love that we all have to do and grow together.
दुखां च तू है सुखां च तू है
A child has three realities of life. He is a material being, he is a human being, he is a divine being.
You embrace the new competency-based testing and assessing of children's learning.
Guide and inspire and cajole and handhold.
Why we are doing things that we are doing over the past 2 years.
We should all be upskilling in life. We should all be future ready and prepared for all of the greatness and all of the challenges that life will pose for us.
So dear friends, make yourself a priority. It's not being selfish, it's necessary.
Which is a reiteration of all that you have achieved in the form of a sweet that comes to you to remind you that you are the creators of this vision.
So I am speaking to you live from Anandnagar campus.
Yes.
I'm surrounded by four wonderful teachers here, and we have just participated in some wonderful discussion at the campus level.
EMS should be a world-class school, and we should nurture such citizens who should be the transmitters of morality, who should be the global leaders of tomorrow, and who should be the agents of social transformation.
Education is not only about marks, it is more about acquiring knowledge.
We have micro-learning at the heart of everything we do. And what we're going to do right now is watch a quick video.
Micro-learning is defined as the breaking down of large pieces of learning into smaller, more manageable parts.
Setting high expectations which inspire, motivate, and challenge pupils.
What we've decided is that the CMS lesson plan has been simplified as regards what detail you would be writing in.
The four C's have been widely instrumental in improving the quality of teaching and making student engagement a well-planned activity in all the City Montessori schools.
So remember, students, study smarter, not harder. By actively developing good study skills and learning strategies, you will keep your motivation high and achieve your goals more easily and more efficiently.
Another strategy you can use is interleave learning, which basically means jumbling up ideas.
Teachers, friends, trust me, with these strategies, you can change the classroom learning into happiness course.
When life gives you a banana, tum usko chheel ke kha jana. When life gives you a banana, tum usko chheel ke kha jana. Always remember what the old man said, tu game bhi rahega high until you are dead. Always remember what the old man said, tu game.
reformed, dear teachers, and we've learnt new pedagogies, skill-based assessments, and support is being provided to you with the coaching approach.
He's a lamp upon ourselves, he's just a lamp.
I will witness, oh my Lord, that thou hast created me to know thee and worship thee.
Looking forward to yet another day in our learning fiesta.
This system of observations is going to be absolutely transparent. When will people come to observe you? What exactly is it will they be observing?
The importance of development observation. You know, it allows, as she mentioned, it allows transparent system of observation.
Five different types of development observations are: the first, by the innovation wing.
The class observation resulted in consultations to improve the overall impact of the lesson in the classrooms.
The education of your students your first concern and ensure to achieve the highest possible standards in work and conduct.
We now are looking forward to internalize these assessments to a greater extent and setting higher goals for both the internal and external assessments.
It is rightly said that we must prepare students for the world of their future, not the world of our past.
Formative assessments, as you all know, it's the most powerful tool in our hands to gauge our students' understanding continuously.
What is your favorite formative assessment strategy and why?
My favorite technique, I would say, is 3-2-1.
What have been your experiences with formative assessment?
Here, I feel formative assessments play a very, very important role. And one of the techniques that I use a lot is hinge questions.
The various techniques you all are using, your classes are surely very interesting and the learners are having a go at it because otherwise they sit passively. So there's active learning taking place.
Filling gaps in learning, adjust your own teaching through these informative strategies.
Feedback strategies.
Bravo, well done!
The key principle is that feedback and formative assessment work hand in hand. They have a symbiotic relationship with each other and cannot be planned in isolation.
How to ensure that feedback is aligned to the desired learning outcomes so that we are very clear about the idea, what they have to learn, what they have to focus on. The Alpha Class methodology is that children are in pairs and they are giving feedback to each other.
You're looking at the data subject-wise, and it also is a way in which you are getting diagnostic details and the pulse of the child, not just subject-wise, but topic-wise also. Is that helping you?
Absolutely helping us, ma'am. And the data is taking us to the direction that we aim to reach at.
It's clear that we ourselves have to model good practice. So feedback is not just relevant for students, it's relevant for the whole community.
Here, analysis is the skill that the teacher wishes to develop in her students. the verb which describes it, and the observable action is an important component of the MLO.
CPDs and PLC sessions have been a great platform for teachers to pool in their ideas of refinement.
It is important that we differentiate the way we teach to best suit all our students' needs.
Remember, no child should be left behind.
Welcome to the third day of the CMS Vision 2025 Conference 3.0.
We are made for service, to care for each other.
My favorite topics today, that's metacognition, because we are now out there in the metaverse.
Jai ho, Jai ho Shankara, Adi Dev Shankara, Tere Jaap ke bina, chale ye saans kis tarah.
Metacognitive knowledge refers to knowledge of task, knowledge of strategies, and knowledge of self-awareness.
Teacher Standard 6, making accurate and productive use of assessment, and consider how we can continue this journey of growth.
A teacher's ability to co-create class norms and ensure positive behavior for learning has been an evident success at our school.
Independent learning, as our young adults would prefer to call it, is learning that learners undertake out with their timetable lessons in response to the guidance from school.
Telling us about the ways in which what kinds of independent learning through homework they are doing.
I feel that is an integral part of the teaching learning process. So the homework that we plan should be very engaging, very interesting for the students.
What resonated with you from the video? Could you identify with any of the experiences?
So the thing that resonated with me was that the homework should be well planned in advance.
Question is, what do you think is the purpose of homework?
Now the basic aim of homework is to reinforce learning in the child.
Have been putting into practice metacognition within their classrooms.
What is education if it does not build character? That is what we need every time, every day, every minute.
The aim of CGCE is to empower learners of all ages in the building of more peaceful, tolerant, inclusive, and secure societies, both locally and globally.
The function of education is to teach one to think intensively and to think critically. Intelligence plus character is the goal of true education.
It is important to focus on the development of soft skills or social and emotional abilities of the students.
The original vision document states that CPD must become a process that is embedded into the ecosystem of CMS.
During the guided learning sessions, we had the opportunity to engage with theory, research, case studies, and our peers' experiences.
It is about team building and well-being, making sure that all stakeholders are taken into the folds. And the leader's duty is to bridge the gap between schooling and learning.
How do you develop the skills? We talked about the tools and techniques and methodologies. When we talk about metacognition, well, that is one approach to how we can learn better.
This is a conference of teachers, and it has been conference by the teachers.
in the 3-day conference on Vision 2025 conference, how to make learning for better for students and teachers.
Look what we've done. What about all the peace that you pledged your only son? What about flowering fields? Is there a time? What about all the